worked as a group more so than we ever have, and it's been the same lineup for 2.5 years now, and I think that's showing itself in a lot of ways on this record. Really happy with how it turned out.
We definitely achieved something different.
This album was more about just being fierce and violent and just super aggressive.
I like the music better on this one, honestly.
This particular record is kind of a return to old form.
It's not trying to like be outside of anything or different or, you know, just a straight up metal record.
Fucking keep it really aggressive and noisy and not take the whole dance rock approach.
We just basically wanted everything to sound more raw and just edgy. Way more pissed off than the last couple albums.
There's a lot of traditional black metal stuff on it, but it's also like a fucking noise record.
It's one thing I've always liked about my listening is every record we try to do, you know, we try to do something different from the last.
This one, we used a little bit more restraint and focused more on the songwriting than on trying to make something that's very strange or, you know, just unusual.
For me, it took tremendous sacrifice, physically and mentally.
Going back to our earlier sound, in a lot of ways, I hope to regain some old fans that we may have lost.
Blake and I set out to write some old school stuff. You know, we wanted to make it, we wanted to go back to the roots of Mechanist Doom. But in the end, you know, only half the record turned out that way.
Well, we kind of wanted to approach this album differently than the last couple, the black metal one and two. Whereas we kind of wanted to go back to more of the Instinct Decay type of vibe, where it's a little more, like, not so much muddy, but just a little more raw, just kind of, I don't know, I guess kind of trying to capture more of the original black metal sound. Not focusing so much on clarity, but more on mood.
We did the psychedelic experimental things with the black metal albums, Assassins and Addicts. There's a central theme, you know, to the lyrical content of both records, but overall, the reason that it's a series and, you know, is its own thing was because we were intentionally being very experimental. And I'm glad we did it, but now it's time to do what I think we do best, which is being a, you know, more or less a black metal band.
So with this record, we kind of approached it where the drums wouldn't be quite as upfront, quite as like punchy. They'd kind of sit back a little more atmospheric. The blast would kind of just become more of a pumping, like heartbeat, you know, like wash. Not so much like the last two, where it was more about the psychedelics. I think the songs kind of called for more of a production like that, you know.
So this is the first record, the Mechanist Doom record you played on?
Yeah, it's the first studio one. I did the live at Roadburn. I'm on that. And then I did a 12-inch with them like 6 months ago. And a few months before that, I did a 7-inch.
I've known Charlie for a couple of years now, and we weren't ever particularly tight or anything previous to him joining the band. But I knew he was a drummer, and he's a damn good one. I love the way he plays. And Chuck Biscuits from Danzig is his biggest influence, and I always loved the way that he played. It's kind of like a less is more approach. His meter's real solid, though. He's got great taste. He could be a lot flashier than he is, so when there is room for him to get kind of crazy, he does, but he doesn't overdo it. Having him come in and join the band was kind of a no-brainer when he told me that he was available.
You start rushing the beat, and that last fill has like a weird hit in there.
We did really everything strict to the click, and I've never been much of like a click track like guy. Like, I've always kind of done everything just natural feel. Still was kind of getting used to that a little bit, although I've had some of it on the last two recordings. I used it and wasn't the problem, but just a little bit of a, you know, I've always had the tendency to play real aggressive and in the pocket, which sometimes translates to slightly ahead of stuff, and people are like, well, you know, they want everything precision on this. Cool. I like how the album turned out, and I like how the drums sound on it. You know, I'm glad I got to be the drummer for this album.
One thing that we made a point of with every song on this record, one question that we had to ask ourselves is, can we recreate this live?